Hello guys, today I will talk about the CSRF attack, about the cross-site request forgery attack, and how to be protected against this kind of attack with Sprint Security. If you're ready for this video, I will just ask you to subscribe to my channel to support my work. And let's go! First of all, what is a CSRF attack? As specified in the OWASP definition, the cross-site request forgery is an attack that forces an end user to execute unwanted actions on a web application in which they are currently authenticated. Let's say I'm a frequent user of a social network website. When the engineers developed the social network, they faced to a problem. A quick search in the web showed them that allowing all the origins to perform actions on their backend is a solution. But maybe this isn't the correct solution. They quickly realized that more requests failed. All the requests which implied some modifications, post, put, delete, or patch. Another quick search showed them another solution. Yes, Sprint Security has already enabled by default CSRF. From there, all the websites seemed to work perfectly. What was the first mistake made? Allowing all the origins to perform requests on the backend. This means that someday I may receive an email, which seems coming from my preferred social network. This email opens a login page similar to my preferred social network, but with a different URL. With precaution, I directly close the browser. Nevertheless, something bad already happened. By clicking on the email link, a script was called. This script stole the session information of the social network and shared some sensitive information with the attacker. If it were a shopping website, the action could be buy something and send it to the attacker's address. All of this just by clicking in the email link. So, to prevent all of this, I have multiple actions. The first one is to only authorize my trusted frontends to call my backend. Sprint Boot is prepared to have the frontend integrated inside the Sprint Boot application, to have a server-side rendering. But this is not always the case. In my case, I have a React application which is delivered from a separated server. This separated server has a different address. This is the only address that must be allowed to perform requests to my backend. I can also add all of my different environments and my local host to debug locally. This will allow the pre-flight requests. Those are the options requests. The options requests will check if the backend accepts requests from a given origin and for a given verb. Those requests are only sent for modification verbs, post, put, delete, or patch. And the response will contain the header access control allow origin, with the origin accepted. This means that I must also accept the options method. Let's go now to the security config, where I've disabled the CSRF. As said, Sprint Boot enables it by default. So let's enable it again and configure it correctly. This way, I tell Sprint to store the CSRF token in a cookie. Setting HTTP only to false allows my frontend to access the value of the cookie. This cookie will be sent back at each request made to the backend. This ensures me that not only I'm the only frontend I'm performing requests to my backend, but that I'm the one which initiated the communication. This cookie will have an initial value at the beginning, and with each correctly received request, the value will change. This makes my communication unique, and the value of the cookie with a time range validity. Another option to store the token is in the session, but my application is currently a stateless application, so I must choose this option. And to get this initial token, I will need a controller. Let's create this controller. From my frontend, I will need to call this endpoint to get my initial token. And this endpoint must be accessible without any authentication. To increase even more the security, this token must be sent in both the cookie and a header named XSRF. This way, my Spring Boot application will have two channels to validate the validity of the request, with the cookie and with the header. That's why I will need to authorize this header. Let's now test my communication. Here is my React frontend. If I reload the homepage, I can see the CSRF request. Here is the option request, where the response contains the access control allow origin with the frontend origin. And the CSRF request with the token. Let's now log in into my application to see some requests to the backend. I can see the pre-flight request as before, and the signing request. This time, in the request, I can see both the header and the cookie sent to the backend. And in the response, I can see the cookie is sent back with a new value. The following request to the backend will follow the same pattern. The preflight, which is accepted, and the new request with a new generated CSRF token. Let's recap what I've done to protect my Spring Boot application against the CSRF attack. I must authorize only the trusted origins to request my backend. I must enable the CSRF protection with the cookie repository as I am in a stateless application. I must accept the options method and the XSRF header from my requests. And finally, I must create an additional control to generate the first token. That's all for this video. I hope you liked it. If you're interested in more videos about the security, like this one, just let me know in the comments. Just tell me which attack you're interested in and I will try to make a video about its protection. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up and see you in the next video. Bye!